Hello everybody, Brooke Cormier here. I know I haven't posted in a really long time. It's just been a crazy past few months, but I figured for my first post back, I would make a little tutorial video. And I've actually been receiving a lot of requests for tutorials, but I've just been so busy lately that I haven't got around to being able to do one. If you've been following me on social media, you've probably noticed that I've been completing a lot of the little 3x3 food paintings. And I actually have a couple commissions for 3x3s that I need to complete, so I figured now would be the best time to show you step by step how I work through one of these paintings. So I just want to let you know that I'm not a teacher, I've never taught a tutorial before, and I really don't know how good I'm going to be at it, but I will try my best and hopefully you learn something. Okay, so here I'm working with a 3x3 canvas that I just ordered a bunch of these off of Amazon. I've got my Masterson Stay Wet palette. It's the Super Pro palette, and honestly, if you're a painter out there, especially who paints in acrylic, this is definitely worth investing in. It keeps your paints wet up for days and days at a time, and it's going to save you so much money and having to buy new paint. So the first thing that I like to do when I'm doing these tiny food paintings is I prep the background, and I always like to give it this this vignette effect. So the lightest shade of the color is in the middle, and then it's gradating to a darker shade towards the corners. So here I have my Liquitex Basics paint. I have titanium white in a lot of it because I find I use a lot of white in my paintings. And this is a primary blue, and this is a dioxazine purple. So this is actually going to be a little commissioned painting, and I have two of them with the same background, so that's why I got a lot of blue out here. And the client requested a royal blue, so that is what I'm going to be mixing. So I find that the primary blue is just almost a bit too much on the green side, so I'm just mixing some purple in here until I have the shade that I'm looking for. And right here I'm mixing the darkest color, so this is going to be the color that's going to appear on the very outside of the vignette, like in the corners. So just mix this here, and once I'm satisfied, what I'm going to do is paint the whole canvas this one color and then dry it. I'm painting the background with a Curry's brush. It's a number 8 round series 2600. And so, as I said, I'm just going to paint the entire background this one color, the royal blue. And I like to paint the sides too, because I think that it gives it a nice finished look. Since I'm impatient, I like to dry my my canvases like this. Since it's acrylic paint, it dries quickly, but sometimes not quickly enough. So I always have a normal, just regular hair dryer, and I'll use that to speed up the drying process. Now that the second layer is dry, we are going to paint, or the first layer is dry, we're going to paint on a second layer. And the reason that I like to do this is because sometimes after you paint on just the first layer, you can still see the white of the canvas showing through at some parts, making it look kind of streaky and unfinished. So that is why the second layer, I think, should always be required. So on the sides too, I want to make sure that it looks finished all the way around. Okay, so this part is important and you have to make sure that you're going to be working quickly. So while the paint is still wet on your canvas, you're going to want to grab some titanium white onto the tip of your brush and then just kind of splot it right in the middle of the canvas and mix it around just a little bit. And now at this part, you're going to want to take your brush and drag it in a circular motion and making sure that the handle of the brush is turning in your hand with the brush, because if you don't do this, then the bristles of the brush are going to fold over one another and then it's not going to be the right look. So you're going to let the brush move in your hand and then spiral this color, pushing the white into the blue and out and out. And then I spiral back in, pick up more of that white, and then spiral back out again. And then kind of repeat that a couple times, just to make sure that we get that really nice gradient that we're looking for. And this took me a very long time to get used to, and it's still one of the trickiest parts in the painting to date. Okay, we'll do this one more time. And we're just gonna grab a little bit more white and just kind of plunk it in the middle again, just to get this a little bit lighter. And it's all about like what you think looks good. Like personally for me, I like to have a drastic change in shade from the middle to the out, but you don't have to if you don't want to. So just mix that color right in the middle. And I'm gonna get some of this paint off of my brush and then continue mixing. So now there's no paint on my brush and I'm just using the paint that's on the canvas. And that is the vignette that I'm looking for. So now I'm going to dry this and we can get started on the painting. So now that the background is prepped, we can start on doing the painting. And this painting is actually going to be of a little gumball machine. So I have the reference photo in front of me, just on my laptop screen. And what I'm going to do first is get just a regular lead pencil, like this one here. It's just a Bic pencil. And I'm going to sketch out just a rough outline of the gumball machine so that I can make sure that it is exactly where I want it to be and proportions are accurate before I start going in with the paint. Now that I have drawn the outline of the gumball machine in pencil, I'm going to fill in the composition just with white. So I'm gonna block that in, just dip my paintbrush in here, and I'm doing this because I find it way easier to paint with a white background when I'm doing all these tiny details than on a dark background, because I know that I'm going to be putting in a lot of different colors with all these gumballs here. So you can't put just yellow paint over top of a dark blue background and expect it to show up perfect. Yellow is a really translucent color, and so you need to have a white background. So I'm just going to block in the whole thing white, and then we'll get started on filling in the details. Finished blocking in the composition with the white paint. Now I'm going to fill in all of the details, basically painting the whole gumball machine now on top of this white paint. So as I mentioned earlier, how yellow is a translucent color. Well, the body of this gumball machine is going to be red, and red is also a pretty translucent color. So when you would layer it on to, say, a color of this background, it wouldn't have that, you know, fire hydrant red look that I'm looking for. So that's when having a white background is really handy. So I'm just gonna go and fill in all these details now.
Baby, 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 baby Okay, now that I have filled in all of the details of the gumball machine, the next step is to do a little bit of a shadow. And I do this in all of my food paintings just because I feel like it brings it right to the next level. It really gives it like a three-dimensional look. And a lot of the times I find that the shadow is one of the hardest parts in the whole painting, just because it's very improvised and sometimes it's hard to figure out the direction it's supposed to be going in and whatnot, but let's give it a shot. I'm just mixing up this background color that I've made with a little bit of black, and especially with this piece it's very dark, so you're gonna need a black, or I'm gonna need a very dark color for the shadow. And voila! I have finished the shadow, and now the last part of the whole painting to do is my signature. And for that, and what I've been using for the tiny details, is this little brush, and it is a synthetic Skoda Marfil brush. It's very, very thin. There's only a few hairs on it, but it works like a charm, and I really couldn't live without it. It's the best brush I have for signing my paintings. So let's sign it. And there you have it. There's one 3x3 gumball commission ready to be shipped to Rock Island, Illinois. So I hope that you learned something from this video. If you have any questions, you can comment below and I will try and get back to you in a timely manner. I appreciate your likes and comments. If you liked this video and you want to see more, you can subscribe to my channel. I am Brooke Cormier, and I'll see you next time.